Good morning, everybody. Why don't you go ahead and stand with us? We're going to enter into God's presence this morning. Amen. JJ and Ishmael for coming today. Everybody's on vacation, and so we have their beautiful talents here helping us, and We just want to welcome everybody who's here this morning. Father, we just lift you up today, Lord. We thank you for who you are, Lord God. We thank you for your blessings, Lord God. We just thank you for who you are, Lord God. And we know that in the midst, Lord, of all of our trials, Father God, that we have a testimony, Lord God, and that you are reaching out, Lord. And we just thank you, Father God, for Sue, who's here today, Lord God, and that you are just, that you've helped her to recover from her stroke, Lord God. And we just thank you for your miracles and your blessings, Lord God, and that your continued favor and strength is over us, Father, and guiding us, Lord God. And we just pray for those who are here today, Lord, and just need a touch from you, God. I pray, Lord, that your spirit will just seep into their minds and their hearts, Lord, and that you will fill them with a peace and a joy and a strength that only your love can give, Father. We just lift up Jalen as he's in the army right now, Father God, and our family, Lord God, as we journey through this time, Lord God, of seeking you, Lord, and we just know that you are mighty, Father God. And Lord God, we just speak our testimony to you today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Grace,
praise you, Jesus. You are worthy, Father God. We praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Turn praise started. You turned bones into armies. You turned seas into highways. You're the only one who cares. You're the only one who cares.
Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing.
Nothing is better than you.
Still be moved. Strongholds are still being loosed. God, we believe. Yes, we can see it. That wonders are still waiting. Bodies are still being raised. Giants are still being slain. Yes, we can see it, that wonders are still what you do. We are here for you. Come and do what you do. We are here for you. Come and do.
Set
our
Give them a refreshing and a renewing, Lord. They're going to take a second week off, Father, and we just pray, Lord, that you give them that strength, that peace, Father. We thank you for our guest speaker that's here today, Lord. I pray, Father God, that you just speak through her, Father, and that we're able to hear the word, Father, from you, Lord. We pray for each and everybody that's here, Lord, that you will just give us your peace, Lord. I pray, Father God, for your strength over everybody here. I pray, Father God, for healing over everybody here, Lord. We thank you so much for the opportunity to come, Lord, and just worship and give you all honor and glory, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. How's everybody doing? I was tasked to come up and do announcements, and I'm not very good at this, but just bear with me. So yes, Pastor's gone. Him and Kim are gone. They're off at City Council this week, and then they're going to take off next week as well, just for some rest and relaxation. Yeah, go ahead and sit down. Just want to keep them in prayer, that they get home safely, that they have safe travels. We want to welcome Gertie Whedon. This is Kim's mom, and she's going to come and bring the word to us. So come on up, Gertie.
Praise God. Are you there? I can't see you. I better be able to hear you because you'll be able to hear me. I thank God for this privilege. It actually isn't a divine appointment that we can meet together, that we can hear what the Spirit is saying, that we can have our hearts changed by the Spirit of the living God. None of us can change ourselves. We might be able to change ourselves for a few weeks or a few days, but it doesn't last. But what we need, hallelujah, is for the Spirit of God to so consume us that we will never be the same. I was saying to Kirby as we were driving over, I said, it's fun to be an evangelist. You preach hard and then you leave town. So today I'm going to preach. My anointing is for the Holy Spirit. I've traveled the world preaching on revival. But first of all, we have to experience revival ourselves. And may today God bring to each of us revival. And it's a very strange thing which I'm speaking on. I'm speaking on the fire. But first of all, my sermon title is Samson, Let the Fire Fall Again. It's a very strange combination, but this is what the Spirit is saying to this church today. And so as we consider the Holy Spirit in the Old Testament, we find the difference, this is important, between the Holy Spirit in the Old Testament and the New Testament is that in the Old Testament, the Holy Spirit came upon people for a certain task. And as we look in the Old Testament, we remember Abraham on Mount Moriah when he was asked to sacrifice his only son, the son of promise. It had to be the Holy Spirit that came upon him as he walked upon that mountain in obedience to God, not knowing that God would spare Isaac. The Holy Spirit gave him the strength to obey. Noah building the ark. He built the ark. It took him 120 years to build the ark. And people were not kind to Noah. They rejected him and made fun. They'd never seen a flood. And there was no water around in this huge boat. But the Holy Spirit gave Noah strength to endure. We see Moses at the Red Sea with 3 million people behind him complaining that the Egyptians are coming. They're going to overtake us. We're going to die. And there as Moses stood at that Red Sea, I believe that the Holy Spirit came upon him and strengthened him to see that sea divided. Daniel in the lion's den. Nobody's going to stand there and let somebody throw him in the lion's den. Not me. We put up a fight. We'd run. We'd scream. We'd do anything. But Daniel had the power of the Holy Spirit to stand there, not knowing he was going to live, but knowing that Almighty God was with him. Elijah on Mount Carmel, as he stood there with 300 false prophets, and he, the only one who believed that God could send fire from heaven. And as he stood there, in other words, he had a very short prayer. Very long private prayers, very short public prayers. And as he stood there, in other words, and said, God, just be God. And down came the fire. David, as a lad fighting Goliath, how could a young lad do that? How could they have the courage? No, you can't. What we are facing, what you are facing, is impossible. But it is not impossible with God. And so today we are going to see how the Holy Spirit was upon one person in the Old Testament, and then we will briefly go into the New. Samson. Samson was God's champion. Judges 16:4. And it came to pass afterward that Samson loved a woman whose name was Delilah from the valley of Sorek. Delilah was a Philistine. And he was instructed not to deal with the Philistine women. But sometimes people think, I can get away with this. But listen and look what happened to Samson. So Samson went to the Philistines and found these women. And what about the Philistines? Why were they to stay away from the Philistines? The Philistines oppressed, threatened, harass God's people. Israel had no weapons. The Philistines had them all. They had turned Israel's plow. They took their plows even and sharpened them at the Philistine forge. They had constant raids on Israel for 40 years. Then came Samson. He was a promised birth. No, he was no military genius. He had no gift for leading. He only had magnificent, massive strength. He was God's prophet, God's anointed, God's judge. He was to be a champion of a whole nation. He was divinely appointed, divinely chosen. He was a champion of his people. Samson had supernatural strength. He killed a lion barehanded. This is what happened when the Holy Spirit came upon Samson. In the Old Testament, the Holy Spirit came upon people. In the New Testament, the Holy Spirit fills people. Hallelujah! Oh, you're weak. Samson, he killed a lion barehanded. He slew 30 men. He caught 300 foxes and set them on fire. He killed 1,000 men with the jawbone of an ass. He carried the gates of the city to the top of a hill. That's a big deal, but it was 30 miles he carried the gate of the city. God's champion for Israel. After Israel had served under the Philistines for 40 years, then God sent Samuel. God has sent you to that workplace. God has sent you to that school. God has sent you to that marriage. God has sent you to your children. Don't fail God. Then God sends Samuel. Samson's destiny, not Samuel, Samson. His destiny was to overcome the Philistines. Judges 16:4, but, and Samson loved a woman whose name was Delilah, a Philistine. And Delilah, Samson had a weakness for Philistine women. He had a Philistine wife, he had a Philistine prostitute, and he had a Philistine living girlfriend. How could he do that? Because he thought, because he was an exception. We are not an exception to God's rule. We are not an exception to what God has led and put in his word as a pathway of truth and victory. Samson found that out the hard way. And as he was with Delilah, I'm sure she was beautiful, she began to bring him down. Samson loved things that destroyed him. Hallelujah. And the Spirit of God is speaking today to you individually. The Spirit of God is pinpointing in your life the thing that has brought you down, the thing that is going to bring you down, the thing that has could bring you down. And today, you must determine, I shall not be a Samson. I shall be who and what God has destined for me to be. Clap to the Lord. Samson loved things that destroyed him. The weakness of his heart was stronger than the strength of his body. Strength did not lie in his hair or his muscles, but in the relationship and contact and the anointing and the fire he had with his God through the Holy Spirit that came upon him. Samson's choice, Judges 16:4, and it came to pass that Samson loved a woman named Delilah, a Philistine. One thing can bring us down. It's not the big, God's word says, beware of the foxes, the little foxes. It is the foxes that destroy the vines. Samson loved a Philistine. His third Philistine love, his heart became weak and before his body. Delilah cried because he had his head in her lap and she was hired by the Philistines. How does he get his strength? And I love it, as my husband used to say, that he thinks Samson looked like a very small Filipino man. And when, in my, probably not even looking strong, but when the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, came upon him, there was no one or nothing that could stand against him. This is a lesson for us. We say, I can't do it. It's impossible. No one's helping me. No one likes me. No one gives me money. It is possible through the strength of the Holy Spirit in our life. Delilah cried, tell me. And as Samson became worn down through all these Philistine loves, he told her the secret of his strength. For he was a Nazarite, and a Nazarite from his birth. Even before his birth, it was told that he would be a Nazarite, which would not drink strong drink, would not touch the dead, would not cut his hair. And he had his first haircut. He was no longer a Nazarite. He was weak as other men. His love, Delilah, had betrayed him and disappeared. But most of all, the Holy Spirit had departed from Samson. He was helpless to fight back. He was common. He was ordinary. He was like any other man. And I want to tell you, in this last day, these are the last days. We could see Jesus coming in the clouds. The thing that will set us apart is not our popularity or our beauty or our money or our house or our car. It will be the anointing and the strength of the Holy Spirit upon us. Hallelujah. And we sit as weaklings in Delilah's lap and say, oh, it'll be okay. It will not be okay. We will be deceived. His locks of hair were 7. The number of perfection. He had complete strength. He had perfect strength for any task that was given. Why are we grumbling? Why are we complaining? I cannot do this. It tells you have not received the fullness of the Holy Spirit. Because it says in God's word, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. Hallelujah. If you do it in your own strength, you will fail. And the Philistine, it says, and he wist not that the Spirit had departed from him. Some of us, the Spirit has departed and we don't know it. It has been a gradual decline down the slippery slope. One worldly thing after another enters into our life. Everybody's doing it. Well, that's a good sign. It's wrong. It says, narrow is a path and straight that leads to life eternal. Judges 16:20. Lord, may I rephrase that for us today. And we wist not that the Spirit departed from us. Then the next verse. And the Philistines seized him and gorged out his eyes. They bound him with iron chains. They put him grinding in the prison, grinding at the mill, 2 huge stones. And they would strap a horse or another animal, and that animal would turn this stone round and round. But soon they found Samson. And to demean him and punish him, they made him go round and round grinding at the mill, which was the work of women or slaves or horses. He was reduced to such a low estate of a slave. Remember, he was God's prophet. He was God's anointed. He was God's judge. He was God's champion of a nation, God's strong man to a slave. He was stripped of his eyes, his hair, his titles, his anointing, his strength. And most of all, he was stripped of his destiny. One downward step at a time. And this is what the enemy does to us. He desensitizes us. He doesn't just say, push us off the edge of the slippery slope. It's one step at a time. And there he was, the most humble place in a society, a slave. Humiliation to Samson, his God, and to God's people. But Samson the slave remembered his destiny. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the Spirit of God renew your vision today. Let the Spirit of God renew that which he called you to. It may seem simple. It's the simple things that lead to the greatest things in our lives. As we have dismissed simple decisions as, oh, it doesn't matter, or I can do this, we have either put ourselves on a downward trail or an upward path of victory. And his destiny was to defeat the Philistines. He appeared defeated. His dream was ended. But as he was there, grinding away, also he had time to think. He had time to reminisce. He had time to think how he was a promised child, how he had a promised destiny, how he had a special anointing, a fire of the Holy Spirit that no one else had that was to be used for God's kingdom and his glory. And he thought, if I only could fulfill my destiny, if I only could destroy the Philippines, not the Philippines, the Philippines on my mind, I've been there 35 times, If only I could destroy the Philistines. If only I could vindicate my God. And in Judges 16:22, it says, they did not know that his hair began to grow. Ha, ha, ha. Hallelujah, hallelujah. They did not know that his God was a God of restoration. They did not know that his God was a God of victory. They did not know that even if you destroy everything around a person that looks like it will lead them to victory, if they are destined for victory, God can rearrange it all and make victory out of the smallest, most despised thing there is. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't think you're sleeping. I hear a murmur. They did not know. Hallelujah. But sometimes God's people do not know. You do not know the greatness of the God we serve. You do not know what the fire of the Spirit can do within one individual. For fire is contagious. Fire shines. Fire burns. Fire ignites everything around it. So you individually are the key. And so Samson, as he was going round and round and round in those circles, as they spit on him, as they cursed him, as they mocked him, as they said, what kind of God do you serve? Made fun of his God, Jehovah. Did everything they could to bring him down emotionally and mentally. But yet as he stood there, his hair began to grow. And he began to notice, it's a little easier to pull this big stone. His hair was growing. And as it was growing and blowing in the breeze, I believe his repentance was deeper. I believe that God's forgiveness was greater. And as he was there, he was experiencing restoration. Hallelujah. Because God is a restoring God. Right where you are today, he's restoring you to a greater place. Hallelujah. And they did not know. The Philistines had no idea that Samson's God was a God of second chances. So no matter what we've done, where we've been, and as we travel, and we have a van driver, and we found out that this van driver actually committed murder and was in prison. But actually, we have been placed in his life for a reason, so we keep riding with him. And I have testified to him at length. And I tell him, I'm praying for you, Sean. And one day, recently, as we got out at the airport, I said, Sean, he was by the van, and I was on the curb by the suitcases. I pointed at him. I said, Sean, God will get you. Wherever we are, whatever we've done, God is a restoring God. God is a resurrecting God. No matter what is dead in your life, your marriage, your sickness, your children, your grandchildren, if you will be ignited, they will be ignited. God is a restoring God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And Samson said, I have failed, but strengthen me. Oh God, only this once. Do it for your name's sake, that all the glory in our life may go to Jesus. And that which he will restore, and that which he will revive, and that which he will bring back, give all the glory to God. And then came Samson. Woo, woo, woo. Out of defeat, out of disgrace, ready to fulfill his destiny. Then came Samson. Hallelujah. And because he was looking so defeated, because they had thought that they had taken him to the bottom rung, they did not know what God does when he restores. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There he was, out of defeat, out of disgrace, ready to fulfill his destiny. The Philistines call. They were having a great banquet. They were probably drunk, and there was many, many in that room. And so they were looking for entertainment, and so they decided to call for Samson. And so they call for Samson, but because Samson was blind, he could not come alone. They had a very, very small lad go and get Samson. And so this small boy came and let him out because Samson probably was pretty weak. And also, he was no threat. And also, as we said before, he may have looked like an ordinary man when the anointing was upon him, because once again, God's anointing was upon him. Once again, the fire was burning. I'm sure as they let him out, he remembered the Philistines. He did not remember the women. He remembered what the Philistines had done to God's people. He remembered that he was prophesied before he was even born what he would do, that he would be a deliverer. God did not forsake Samson. Samson forsook God. But God took Samson back and restored him and used him. And God can do it for us. God can do it for us. Some of you are in despair over situations in your children, in your marriage, in your family. Don't be in despair. God is a God of restoration. And he can use you as a key of fire and revival to do the work that he has wanted to do all along. Catch it today. Catch the vision of greatness that God has for your destiny and your seed. But the Philistines didn't know Samson's God. God who brings victory out of seeming defeat. And his name, Jehovah, God means the Almighty. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm getting blessed by my own sermon. The Almighty, hello. In your situation, it's not about you and the enemy. It's about you and Almighty God. It's a no-brainer. Almighty God has never lost a battle. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Verse 26. Samson, give Samson's words. Suffer me that I may feel the pillars where the house standeth, that I may lean upon them. What an innocent request. And it says he heard the Philistines, but also he felt the breeze. He felt the breeze blowing in his hair. Oh, hallelujah. Do you feel the breeze, the wind of the Spirit, quickening and awakening that which in your heart was dead? His black hair blowing in the breeze. He heard their threats. He heard their cursing. He heard their laughing. He cried to Jehovah God, Almighty God, remember my destiny. Remember my anointing. I renew my vows one more time. And in the midst of laughing and cursing, Samson pulled on the pillars, and down came the columns, down came the temple, down came the Philistines, down came Samson. God had won a great victory, but the price of victory, his sight was never restored. He perished along with 3,000 Philistines. Samson, God's champion, gave his life for God's cause. You are God's champion. Keep rank. Do not retreat. Keep unity. Quit ye like men. Do not flinch in the fight. Maintain your ground at all costs. Resist. Press forward. Strike deadly blows. Be strong. Keep yourself fit. Learn how to conquer. Die in the contest or win. be God's victorious champion. Hallelujah. And then for a few minutes here, I just want to mention about the New Testament infilling of the Holy Spirit. Acts 2, 1 to 4. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And then suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a mighty rushing wind, and filled all the house. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. This part, oh, this is so exciting. I never tied these two together. This was a Holy Spirit today. This thing about fire, that the fire sat upon their head. And so the manifestation of the tongues upon their head, like as a fire, designated a new kind of sanctuary or temple for the manifestation of God's presence. It would now be the believers, hallelujah, that would be to the temple of the Holy Spirit. No longer individuals. Now it was everyone could be a temple of the Holy Spirit. Wow, every one of us can bear the fire. Every one of us can do signs, wonders, and miracles. Every one of us can live victorious. Every one of us can see answered prayers. Ah, oh, and also it says in Romans 8, 1, but if that same Spirit, hallelujah, we're getting to the shouting part. But if that same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwell in you, it shall quicken your mortal body if it dwell in you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Where is that dead part in your body? Where is that dead hope? Where is that dead vision? Where is that dead pain? Where is that dead grief? Where is that dead idea that you had that has never come about? Where are those ideal children you raised? Where is that husband so far from God? Where is that son on drugs? Oh, don't you know that the same Holy Spirit that came to the tomb and said, come forth to Jesus, lives and dwells in you? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let the hope arise in your heart. Let the victory arise in your spirit. Oh, be overwhelmed with the truth of God's word, that God, Jehovah God, and his precious Holy Spirit is on your side, and there is nothing impossible with him. One more verse. And it shall come to pass afterward, this is the afterward, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. And also upon the servants and upon the handmaids in those days will I pour out of my spirit. Today, we will experience at this time, in this opportunity, in this land and around the world. My children say to me, why do you travel the world? Why do you go where the terrorists are? 53 international trips by December. Why? I said, because with my eyes, I will see this revival. And you can see it too. Because revival starts in you. One person, revival starts in you. If you will seek God, if you will read God's word every day, you will be revived. You will be strengthened. You will be filled with his spirit. You will be used of God right where you are. Yeah. Hallelujah. Because God has placed you where you are. Because that is where your mission field is. Open your eyes to your husband, your children, your workplace, your neighborhood. Just open your eyes and see it. I stayed at home for 34 years and raised lots of children. And I thought that was my ministry. But the Lord has opened doors. But you see, we start where we are. All five of my children love and serve Jesus Christ. All 16 grandchildren, and some of them are young men. A lot of them are young men. Six of them love and serve Jesus Christ. That's your destiny. It's not confusion. It's not division. It's not darkness. It's not sin. It's righteousness, holiness, and the Holy Spirit. And as we follow God's word, that is your destiny. Shall we pray? Thank you, Father, for your word. Your word is truth. Thank you that you have spoken to each of us right where we are. Thank you that you have revived us. Thank you that you have strengthened us. Thank you that you have given us hope. And we thank you, dear Father, that you are going to help us to maintain that which your word has said to us today. In Jesus' name, we pray. Stand to your feet, please. I can't see you. Yes, you're standing. Today, right where you are a candidate for the fire. And it was many years ago that I sat in a church. My husband was a pastor. I'd graduated from Bible college. I was dead. I was dry. And I'm like, why is nothing happening in this church? And the Spirit of God said to me, why is nothing happening in you? One person. If you will determine today, I will seek God. And I had five children. The youngest was 1 year old. And I said, God, if your word is true, and I will seek you, and it happened. I began to be set free without bookstores, without TVs, without whatever. The Spirit of God set me free. And so if you really want to be the one, God is calling the one. Let the Spirit talk to you today. Let the Spirit speak to you today. Raise your hands. Oh, you talk to the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on. Don't be dead. Don't be dry. You've been there long enough. This is your day, your destiny. Your destiny is greatness. Your destiny is greatness. Your destiny is fire. When you stand before God, you will remember this day that you had the choice and the opportunity to do and be what God has called you to do. Hallelujah. Begin to praise the Lord. I praise you. Praise him for what he's going to do. Come on. I cannot hear you. How can anybody else hear you? The devil. Come on. Speak out loud. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. We praise you. We bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, we praise you. We praise you. We praise you. We thank you for victory in your people today. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we cancel out the defeat. We cancel out the darkness. We cancel out the sin. We cancel out the compromise. We cancel out the likeness of the world. And we pray, your word says, holy is the Lord. Call us to holiness. Call us to righteousness, we pray. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. I hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah, hallelujah. We sing the song of victory. Oh, victory, hallelujah. Receive it, receive it. Receive victory in Jesus' name. Receive advancement, receive fire, receive anointing, receive strength in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Today I come against fear. Some of you are experiencing fear. Fear is speaking to you saying it won't last. Fear is speaking to you saying, I do feel comfortable where you are. Don't change. It's a voice of the enemy. We cancel it out in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. You shall move forward. You shall receive more of the Holy Spirit. You shall walk in light. You shall walk in truth. You shall walk in victory. Hallelujah. 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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless you, Lord, who giveth us a victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you wish to come and stand here, I wish to pray a prayer of fire over you. There are those that wish to move upward. There are those that wish to move onward. I'm not going to come down. I'm just going to stand here. But if by the movement of your body, you come and you stand and say, God, I'm moving onward. I want people to know that I'm moving onward. There's accountability. This is not a one-night stand. This is a lifestyle. This is a life of victory. This is a life of moving up. You can't stand still. You're either moving up or you're going back. This is your decision today. This is your decision today. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come, come. Don't let the enemy rob you. I don't care how old you are. I'm old too, but there can be fire. There can be change. There can be newness. There can be freshness. There can be anointing. Hallelujah. You won't make it on your own in this end time. Oh, hallelujah. Just begin to pray, Lord, make me an instrument. Make me an instrument of victory. Anoint me with your fire and fill me with your Holy Spirit to a new level, oh God, where I don't have to speak a word, but as I walk forth, your presence is felt. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. In Jesus' name, Arabashi, Lebeo Katashario, Alabashiti Arabashanka. Who rubba bada yasha, who kiara la, speak in tongues. Hario rara rubba shari ho ho ho. Hario papa papa bandiara rubba shaya. Ratio rubba panda, he kiora rubba sha. Rubba bada yara. Yes, amen, amen. Amen, amen. Let the Spirit rise within you. Let the Spirit rise within you. It's your choice how much of the Spirit you have. Okay, lay down anything that holds you back before I pray for you. Any weight, any sin, lay it down. Lay it down. Anything that keeps you from God's word, anything that keeps you from loving, anything that keeps you from hearing his voice, anything that keeps you from the anointing, anything that keeps the fire dead in your heart. Hallelujah. right now, lift clean hands up as I pray. Lift your hands up. And as you lift them, expect Jehovah Almighty God to do a work. Dear Jesus, we praise thee for your children, these obedient children. You see their hearts. You see their desires. You see the situations that they're in. They're not unique to you. You've seen them all. You know them. You have watched them from their conception. And we pray, dear Father, that the fire, hallelujah, that the fire of the Spirit would rise within them, within a new level, oh God, that they would be igniters, igniters to the lost, igniters in their family, igniters in the stores, igniters at the gas station, oh God, that you would use them. Lord, remind them to seek you. Remind them, oh God, to read your word and to pray. And we pray, dear Father, that you would anoint them. I'm coming by. I'm up here anointing, anointing, a new anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Receive it. Hashakatiya bashata. Hurapati tatara shata. Hurra bashanki. The sweet spirit is here today. Healing wounds. Healing bodies. Setting free. Hallelujah. That is what the anointing does. It breaks the yoke. It breaks the yoke. That which has held you back is broken. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. You're traveling upward. You're traveling onward. You have been ignited. When they ask you, do you have a new hairstyle? Did you get your teeth fixed? No, it's the anointing. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit is a spirit of beauty. Hallelujah. 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 Canceling out the ugliness in our life. Hallelujah. It's gone. Shaka, I've been in deliverance for 40 years. It's gone. In Jesus' name. Renounce it. In Jesus' name. Say, it's gone. It's gone. It's gone. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Yes, let's give the Lord a mighty clap offering.
Set our hearts on you.
we thank you for what you're doing in the lives of this church, Father God. And I just pray, Lord, that as we walk out these doors today, Father God, that we will bless the lives of others, Lord God, that we will recognize, Lord, your anointing in our lives, Lord, that we have your strength, that we have your power, that we are filled with your Holy Spirit, Father God, and with the ability to move mountains, Father God. And I pray, Lord God, as we walk out these doors today, that mountains will be moved, Father God, that giants will be slain, Father God, in your name, in Jesus' name, Lord. We pray strength and peace and comfort, Father God, and joy, Lord God, that only comes from you, Lord Jesus. We thank you. We thank you, Lord God. We need a move of you today, Father. We thank you, Lord, for your anointing and your holy presence, Father God. Bless us today, Lord, as we